We do those two things, we're going to protect Social Security. And Al, that's exactly what we want to do. We want to keep America's promises to our seniors. Donald J. Trump believes that as much as anybody in this country. Social Security ought to go to the people who paid into Social Security, not the people who don't have the right to be here. That's number one.
That was just J.D. Vance, potential vice president, speaking about Social Security, where he stands, as well as former President Trump on Social Security. I'm going to play you that full video clip. Also, we got this, Social Security benefits in 2025, five big changes retirees should plan for. So if you haven't heard about these changes yet, I highly recommend sticking around to the end of the video to make sure you see what these five changes are to your Social Security in 2025, how it may affect your Social Security check in 2025. So stay tuned for those, as well as some other important updates as well. Before I dive into the main content, if you appreciate these Social Security updates, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more Social Security updates. So, J.D. Vance, Vice President, what he said about Social Security. So, he said something last week, maybe a week or two ago, about Social Security. He's spoken about it again. We're going to get into that video clip. Also, we're going to get into this, Social Security benefits 2025, five big changes retirees should plan for. What could happen to your Social Security check in 2025 with these five big changes? So I'm going to get into this article, but first, let's take a listen to what J.D. Vance has to say about Social Security.
Do that. Okay, we've got another question from Al. Al is right over here. Hello, Al.
Good afternoon, Senator. My name is Al Alexander. I'm from Harrisburg, North Carolina. I served in the United States Air Force for many years.
God bless you, Al. Thank you.
My question is about Social Security. And I heard many people around here, not here, but otherwhere, say that Republicans want to end Social Security. What I want to know is, what is the plan to protect Social Security?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well, Al, again, you know, a very good, a very important question, and thank you for your service. And let me say this, that when Kamala Harris says that we're going to go after Social Security, it's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. Donald Trump was president for 4 years. He already protected Social Security, and he's going to do it again. Now, here's what we're going to do, Al. The most important thing, the biggest unexpected strain on our Social Security reserves is that we have got billions and billions of dollars going to illegal aliens who have no right to be in this country. Social Security ought to go to the people who paid into Social Security, not the people who don't have the right to be here. That's number one. And the second thing, I mean, look, Social Security, if you get the illegal aliens off of Social Security and you stop politicians from raiding the Social Security budget to pay for their ridiculous spending, we actually can very easily get Social Security on a sustainable pathway, but we've got to stop people like Kamala Harris from, one, trying to give it to illegal aliens, and two, raiding Social Security to pay for her radical ideas. We do those two things, we're going to protect Social Security. And Al, that's exactly what we want to do. We want to keep America's promises to our seniors. Donald J. Trump believes that as much as anybody in this country. He's already done it. He's going to do it again. Thank you, Al.
You know, J.D., while we're on the subject of lies from the Democrats, I mean, I don't know how much time y'all got tonight. But let's quickly just make it very clear for anybody watching, listening, or anybody want to tell your friends, the lie of Project 2025, and why is it that the Democrats would go out of their way, knowing it is a lie, J.D., knowing that Donald Trump has said this has nothing to do with him, why would they go on and continue to tell this lie?
Well, Laura, you know, you just asked me to enter the mind of Kamala Harris, and that's a very dark place. But my guess is she talks about this because she's got nothing else to talk about, and she can't run on her record, right? Kamala Harris can't run on lowering the price of groceries because groceries went up by 25% under her leadership. She can't run on lowering the price of housing because housing is 40% more expensive because of her leadership. And we know she can't run on closing the border because she opened the border. So what she's going to do is lie about Donald J. Trump instead of tell the American people that she screwed up and they shouldn't send her anywhere near the Oval Office. Now, I happen to think that if Kamala really believes what she says, Laura, and she really wants to lower the price of groceries and lower the price of housing and secure the southern border, she is welcome to vote for Donald J. Trump. There's 11 days left, and we welcome. But the spirit of bipartisanship is alive in this hangar. We would welcome the support of Kamala Harris. I think it'd be the most honest thing she did done in public life. But, Laura, you know, and Al, your question made me think about this, that so Laura and I both have toddlers, right, or close to it. Your kids are a little bit older. I've got a 7, 4, and 2-year-old. And the thing I'll tell you about toddlers is that when they lie kind of like Kamala Harris does. And Aaron, let me give you an example, okay? So I'm a baker. You may be surprised that me and my 4-year-old.
You know who I am, too?
Yeah.
Yeah, I went to culinary school.
That's awesome. Yeah. I didn't know that.
No, go ahead. Sorry to interrupt your story. I love that we know this about each other now.
You know, I'm a baker. So my 4-year-old boy and I were baking an Oreo cake a couple weeks ago. And you've got to, like, break up the Oreos and put it in the cake. And I go to the bathroom and I come back and half the Oreos are gone. And I say, son, what happened to the Oreos? And he didn't kind of say, oh, the dog ate them or oh, one of my siblings ate them. He said, I didn't eat the Oreos. You did. And this, Al, is Kamala Harris is trying to bankrupt Social Security, but you talk to her about it and say, oh, no, I'm not trying to do that. You did. Or Kamala Harris, you opened the border. She's actually running on the idea that the reason the border is open is not because of her policies. She's been in power the last 4 years. It's because of Donald J. Trump. That kind of lying is so brazen and so dishonest. Only 4-year-olds and only Kamala Harris accuse us of doing the very thing she's already done.
I love it. Or she'll just rip it off, like no tax on tips. She'll just rip it off if she needs to, right?
All right. What are your thoughts on what J.D. Vance had to say about Social Security? What are your thoughts on J.D. Vance in general? Who do you want to win, Trump or Harris? We are almost at Election Day, and we'll probably find out within a few days who is going to be the new president of the United States of America. Who are you voting for? All right, let's get into this. Social Security benefits in 2025. 5 big changes retirees should plan for. So, what are these 5 changes? Number 1. Of course, we got cost of living adjustment, a measly 2.5% increase. So that's an average increase of $50 per month $50 per month there. So not much, an extra $600 a year. Basically, the increase is going to go from $1,927 to $1,976 for the average person. So that $50 increase there. And then we have maximum taxable earnings going up. So the maximum taxable earnings in 2024 is $168,000. In 2025, it's going up to $176,000. Number 3, we got maximum Social Security benefit also set to increase. So the maximum is going to go from $3,822 in 2024 to $4,018 in 2025. This maximum applies to those retiring at the full retirement age, which is 67. All right, then we got number 4 here. Average benefit for spouses and disabled workers is increasing too. So the average benefit will increase across the board in 2025, and that includes benefits for people such as widows, widowers, and disabled. And here's how it breaks down. So we have the SSA says the average widowed mother with 2 children will see an increase from $3,669 to $3,761. Then we have the age widows and widowers living alone will see their benefits increase from $1,788 to $1,832. Then we have the benefit will increase for disabled worker with a spouse and 1 or more children from $2,757 to $2,826. So we got some increases going on there. Then also, number five, Social Security adjusts earnings test exempt amounts. So what this is, what the numbers are here, if you start collecting Social Security before full retirement age, you can earn up to $1,950 per month in 2025. Before the SSA will start withholding benefits at the rate of $1 in benefits for every $2 above the limit. In 2024, the earnings was $1,860 per month. So yeah, we have increases there, and those are the changes. Let me know, is your Social Security check going to change from these changes coming in 2025? Let me know down in the comments below, and that is all the news that I have for you today to hopefully brighten your day a bit. Here's my daughter Bella's tip of the day.
Hi guys, this is Bella's tip of the day. I want to say that never let bad vibes take over you. You have to let the good vibes just let you free. You have to always be good and always be humble and always be great to everybody. And I love making these tip of the days for you guys because you guys are my friends. Bye!
I want to do a tip of the day. Hi guys. Hi. This is my tip of the day. I want to say don't go on the road. If you cross, you'll get smushed. And have a great day. Bye.
If you want to see the latest of what Kamala Harris had to say about Social Security and how your Social Security personal finances may be affected, you're going to want to click this video over here. I have a video clip of her speaking about Social Security. So click that video now, and I'll see you in that video. Take care, be safe. Thank you for watching.